Something is amiss with Emil. Take care not to stray too far from him.
Right.
Falling behind. Falling behind.
Scrap of paper.
This used to be some manner of magical research facility.
This must have been where I was...
Emil!
I'll be okay. We need to keep going. Sorry for the trouble.
Thank you.
meal is falling. Project number 6. So this was some sort of weapons laboratory.
What the hell was going on down here?
What was I doing here?
I have doubts as to whether or not Emil will be able to continue.
I'm fine. Let's just go.
Thank you.
Emil is falling behind.
Sure you're okay, Emil?
I'm a weapon? What does that even mean?
It appears he's trying to remember something.
You're gonna be fine.
Am I? Am I really?
Your past makes no difference. We'll support you no matter what.
At any rate, you would hardly be the first member of our merry band to have issues.
I remember now. I remember everything. We used to be humans. Normal humans. Just a bunch of regular human kids like you'd see anywhere. And then we came here. They wanted to turn us into weapons. So they used magic to perform terrible experiments on us. Eventually they succeeded. They managed to create a perfect weapon. The name of that weapon was Number 6. But soon they lost control of Number 6, and the experiment was deemed a failure. They had to create a weapon that could petrify Number 6 and seal it away. So they created me. I'm Number 7. I'm a weapon.
Weapon or no weapon, you're still a meal to us.
Thank you. This is Number 6. She's my sister.
This thing is alive.
My sister is the greatest weapon ever made, and...
Yes, go on.
And with her power, I could eradicate my petrification curse.
So what's the plan here?
First, you have to promise me something.
Hmm?
If my sister somehow manages to swallow me up... My original self becomes lost. I'm afraid I may try to hurt all of you. And if that happens...
No! Wait!
Then I want you to kill me.
You have to get him out of there, now!
I'm on it. We're not gonna lose anyone else.
Hurry! There's still time to save him!
I know there is!
Magic is the only way to damage this one. Stay your weapons. Such attacks will hurt Emil as well.
How is magic any different?
He is highly resistant to it.
Then let's kill that thing with magic and get Emil out of there! This thing's way too quick!
Doubtless harm the boy. We must use magic to defeat this beast.
Emil, we're coming for you.
Come back to us. Thank you. Are you all right?
I'm still alive. I feel my sister's power inside me. I think I can control my abilities now.
Yes, we're all quite pleased. Now get out here already.
Just a second. I can't see very well. No, don't! Don't look at me!
Emil, what's wrong?
Stay back!
Good God!
Come back, Emil. You've been through a lot.
But my body... I can't stand to be with you when I look like this.
What did I tell you? We're here for you. No matter what. Can you see my face?
You look just like I thought you would. You look really cool.
Right.
I'm okay now. If this is how I look now, then so be it. I was terrified at first, but it's not all bad, you know? I have the magic I wanted, and I can use it to bring Kaine back to us.
Emil.
We should hurry. She's waiting. I sure hope seeing me doesn't petrify her. You know, in fear?
I see this transformation has not stolen your terrible sense of humor.
Whenever I interacted with Kaine, I was reminded about something from my past. Maybe my mind has been confusing her with my sister this whole time. Anyway...
Beast approaches.
Oh, I know.
this creature must have. How did it even survive these past 5 years?
I'm not gonna let this happen again. It dies today!
I saw it. It's lighter.
It's not the blade, but the skill of the user. Strike it down! Finding her. We need a way to locate the Shadow Lord.
By the way, this is for you.
Is that a lunar tear?
It's not as good as your grandmother's, but I tried.
No, it's great.
Kaine waking from her long petrified sleep. Emile's unflagging kindness. Our reunion was a happy one, and we let it wash over us like rain. That is, until Devila and Popola had to go and ruin it all.
Are you kidding me? You can't be serious!
Please, try to understand. People are tired and scared, and I'm sorry. I'm sorry you have to bear the brunt of that.
This is crap, and you know it!
It's okay. We can sleep outside.
No one's sleeping outside. You and Kaine saved this village, and now they want to run you out?
People are afraid of us. And really, I understand. I mean, look at me. As long as you're still with us, I can deal with it. Right, Kaine?
I'm used to sleeping outside.
But...
we'll see you later.
Sorry about this.
What is the matter?
Kaine always sleeps outside. I never thought about that until just never even occurred to me. Damn it.
We should turn in.
I didn't get much sleep that night. For the first time in my life, I hated Devila. For the first time in my life, I doubted Popola. But those feelings are pointless in the end. They said and did what they did for the sake of the village. To protect it from the horror of the Shades. Really, how can I blame Devila and Popola? In the end, I'm just as bad. Because I never once stopped to think about Kaine and Emile's situation myself.